When you reach this place, you can barely tell there is any serious business taking place. It looks deserted. It is shocking to learn that this is where Elibokwo Primary School is situated, a government-aided primary school. The government-aided primary school has a population of over 700 students.
These are the characteristics of local rabbits.
The stones and the broken timber act as classroom furniture for hundreds of learners in this school, while the trees are the only shelter for the learners. During examinations, the learners bear the scorching sun or the wetness during the rainy season.
Normally, when it starts to rain, students leave the school and run home. Therefore, it makes learning very, very difficult. When it rains, it starts to rain very early at dawn. And because of no classrooms, children tend to delay home. And the school will start at around 10.
Ronald Aganza, the head teacher, explains that the available classroom can only accommodate students of lower primary, while the other older students in upper primary have to bear the situations.
If this school had a permanent classroom constructed, the enrollment in this school was going to be very big. But because of this, the enrollment has become low. Children continue to move to other nearby schools because of having no classrooms. And learning outside has affected. Learning outside has become a problem.
Besides inadequate classrooms, Angaza adds that teacher absenteeism is another challenge affecting the school. This has also forced learners to shun school as they fear wasting their time to come, only for teachers not to show up.
Teachers will not come timely to the learners as their roads are bad, because most of the teachers reside at various homes. They don't reside in the school because there is no accommodation for teachers in the school, which is another challenge we are facing here.
By the time we came here, the place alone was too scary. Even we did not know why we were brought here. We got children, we are very few. There is no houses. The place was all bushy.
These dire conditions compelled officials from Plan International to offer financing support for the construction of a modern classroom block and teachers' houses, plus a water tank and a latrine to improve sanitation at the school. The ongoing project is aimed at improving education and health services in former war-torn areas, especially northern Uganda and West Nile regions. Report compiled by Peace Navuga for the news.